Today, we're talking about calves, where it's the second most injured region in runners, after the knees, how training them can make you a better runner and prevent tears, Achilles tendonitis, shin splints and others. It's an incredible piece of equipment. Salut everyone, my name is Stefan. Welcome to Why Do Runners Have Muscles? Where I try to explain the basics of running anatomy so that you can understand not only how to protect yourself against injuries, but also how to run more efficiently. Let me introduce you to the main muscles of the calf. The most important one for distance running might surprise you because you can't really see it. It's called the soleus and it runs right behind the shin bone, all the way down through the Achilles tendon onto the heel. So its purpose is, when the foot is on the floor, to lift the heel up. It's made mostly of fibers that are designed for long-lasting efforts and endurance. Sitting right on top of the soleus, you've got the gastrocnemius. The gastrocnemius is the visible fleshy part of your calf. It runs from the thigh bone down to the Achilles tendon and onto the heel. So its purpose is to bend the knee and, when the foot is on the floor, to push the heel upwards as well. It's made of mixed fibers that are designed a little bit more for shorter efforts, so they will tend to fatigue faster. So why do runners have a soleus and gastrocnemius? They provide the power to your foot to propel your body up in the air and forward. Since running is a one-legged activity, they will also stabilize the foot. So right when your foot hits the floor, as your body weight goes over to the front, the soleus will start building up energy into the Achilles tendon, like this. As the back leg starts to straighten up, the gastrocnemius starts pulling on the heel. At the end of that propulsion phase, the energy built up in the Achilles tendon is released. Half of the forces that lift you off the floor comes from the calves. That's pretty spectacular. What you can take away from that is that those two muscles, the soleus and the gastrocnemius, attach to the same tendon on the heel, the Achilles tendon, and they work in pairs together. So when the soleus, designed for endurance, is weak, then the gastrocnemius, not designed for endurance, needs to compensate, can get overworked, and can get injured. So let's test for weakness of the gastrocnemius and the soleus. One thing to always keep in mind when you're doing single-legged exercises is to look for asymmetries. Is one side stronger than the other? Always try to fix asymmetries first. Stand in front of a wall. You can start from the floor or you can use a step. If you're a zero-drop runner, then I suggest that you use a step to make sure that you get the full range of motion in your tests. On one leg, heel raises keep your leg straight all the way to the top at a rate of about one heel raise per second. Count the number of repetitions that you can do with good form. As a distance runner, you should be able to do at least 30. For the soleus, you're going to do exactly the same, but you're going to bend your knees over 60 degrees. So we're kind of taking that gastrocnemius out of the equation, because when you bend your knees, it's not going to be very efficient at lifting the heel up. And we're looking roughly for the same numbers for the soleus. But that soleus test has not been researched well, so I'm going to give you a second test. Wall squat on a single leg. Keep your knees at about 90 degrees or slightly above if you have any issues. Raise your heel and hold it for as long as possible. If your soleus is strong enough, you should feel your quads starting to burn. If you feel your calves, you need to strengthen them. Salut, c'est Stéphane from the future, and as I'm editing this video, I just realized I forgot to say something. The first reflex when the calf starts to hurt or gets sore is to stretch it. That is not always a good idea. In fact,
if your muscles are fragile at the moment, or if you've torn a little bit of the fibers, if you stretch it, it's like stretching an overused rubber band. You might damage it even more.
Most likely, it's a strength issue. And stretching is not going to change anything to a calf's strength. So you can do some gentle massages to release it. But most importantly, you need to get onto a strengthening program. Back to our video. Let me know if this format was interesting to you, and if it was, please hit the like button. And if you want to see some calf exercises, please check out this video, and I'll see you there. A bientôt!